I'm going to open the home page to view the workflow diagram. This is my home page. Now there's three windows that we're going to use to process bills in QuickBooks. They are enter bills, pay bills, and write checks. Now these three windows can either be accessed through this home page. Notice I'm going to click on enter bills and it gives me the enter bills window. That's the same as if I went to vendor enter bills. The pay bills window, here's the name of the window. I can also get there by going to vendor pay bills. Gives me the same window. And down here with write checks, which is in the banking section, write checks obviously opens up the write checks window. I could also get there by going to banking write checks. You could also use a shortcut of Control W if you like shortcuts. Remember, the textbook is going to show you how to use these windows. It does not mention the home page much, but most students like to use the home page because it shows a visual representation or a visual diagram of the workflow. Now let's talk about the enter bills window. This window is used only when you receive a bill, but you do not, I repeat, do not want to pay it right away. By using the enter bills window, you can then keep track of unpaid bills. Notice when I point to the icon, the little tooltip pops up and tells you when to use the window. It says, use this window when you want to enter outstanding bills from vendors. Let's talk about the pay bills window. You use this only when you are paying a bill that had been previously entered in QuickBooks. Notice the workflow diagram. The arrow goes from here to here. So to use this pay bills window, a bill must have already been entered in the enter bills window. And if I point at the icon, I want my little hint about what this window is used for. Notice it says, use this window to pay outstanding bills you've already entered into QuickBooks. And that leaves our third window for processing bills. It's the write checks window. Use this when you receive a bill and you decide to pay it immediately. Since you're paying immediately, there is no need to enter the bills in the enter bills window, since that window is only used to keep track of unpaid bills. Notice that if I point to the icon, it tells me when to use the window. Use it when you want to write a check that you have not entered, that you have not entered as a bill in QuickBooks, or to record a cash transaction. Okay, now it's important that you use the correct window for the correct type of transaction. Failure to use the correct window could mean that your assignment is incorrect. So here are three scenarios similar to certain scenarios in your textbook. Our task is to decide which window would we use. The first scenario, received a bill for rent for the month of April from XYZ Company, $600, paid immediately. Pause the video and see if you can determine which of these three windows we should use to process this transaction. Because it was paid immediately, you need to use the write checks window. Here's another scenario. We received a $1,200 bill from Dewey, Cheatham & Howe, Incorporated for legal consultation, invoice 34983. Pause the video and see if you can figure out which window you should use to enter this transaction. Notice the transaction description does not say that it was paid. This means it was on account. In other words, the company is going to pay it later. So you must use the enter bills window. So let me enter that bill. I choose Dewey, Cheatham & Howe and say it is on 12/31/2012. The reference number is invoice number 34983. for $1,200. Terms net 30, and it's for legal consultation expense. Now the last scenario. Paid in full, Dewey Cheatham & Howe Incorporated, invoice 34983. Notice that it does not say that we received the bill in this transaction. They are implying that it has already been received and entered into QuickBooks. Just to make sure, we click on the Pay Bills window, and we look for Dewey Cheatham & Howe, and we look for an invoice number, also known as a reference number, for 34983. So we would check this to pay the bill. And we want to assign a check number, and let's say we paid the bill on January 31st. We would say pay selected bills, and we choose a check number. That's it. We're now done.